Applying patient payments in TRAKnet 3.0. From the main menu, navigate to the billing dashboard. Click on the payments icon. Here you will be able to add insurance, patient, or provider payments. You will also be able to search for payments that were previously applied, changing the date range, and clicking the refresh button. The filters for unapplied only, insurance, patient, provider, and deleted are to the right of the date search. To add a new payment, click Add Patient. In the lookup box, type the patient's last name. Click Enter or click Search. In the search list, highlight the patient and click OK. The date paid defaults to today's date. Enter the amount paid. Enter the type of payment from the drop-down menu. If the type of payment chosen is check, a check number field will open. If the type of payment chosen is credit card, you can type the authorization number for the credit card in the auth check number field. If the type of payment is cash, no check number field will be available. Check the copay box if this is a copay. You may enter comments in the comments field. When finished, click the Save button. The Charges tab is now available on the right. Clicking the Charges tab, you will have a list of the patient encounters that this payment can be applied to. On the far right, you have filters for showing positive balances only. Unchecking this box will show any negative or zero balance encounters as well. Show pending charges checkbox. Unchecking this box and hitting the refresh will show only patient responsible balances. Click in the amount field of the encounter that you wish to apply a payment to. Type the amount of payment to be applied. Click the Add button to the right to add the payment to the encounter. The applied payment is now visible in the lower portion of the screen. This payment can be removed by selecting the Remove button. If the payment was to be posted to another encounter, simply highlight that line, type the amount paid, and click the Add button. If the amount being paid is the balance of the claim, you can simply click the Balance button. Once the payment has been applied, you can use the New or Close button at the top right to start a new payment or to close this payment and return to the payment screen. Payments can also be applied in the patient's chart. Click to the chart. Search for your patient using the patient search button. Highlight the patient and click OK. Click on the billing tab and then click on the ledger. In the ledger view, on the right-hand side, you can view payments, choosing insurance, patient, or provider. We're going to add a patient payment. Enter the amount of the payment, the type of payment, check number if appropriate, and comments, then click Save. The Charges tab will appear. Again, filters to the right, positive balances only. We'll remove any zero balances. Unchecking positive balances only allows you to see those zero and negative balance encounters. Always click the refresh button to refresh the screen. Unchecking show pending charges and clicking refresh will show you only patient responsible charges. Click in the amount field of the line that you wish to apply the payment to. Type the amount of payment being added and click the Add button. The payment is now visible in the bottom portion of the screen. Click Close to return to the patient's chart. Payments can also be made in a patient encounter. From the ledger screen, we're going to double-click on a patient encounter. In the invoice screen, change your view to the payment view. Patient payment from the drop-down, entering the amount of money paid, the type of payment, check number, copay if appropriate, clicking Save, click on the Charges tab, scroll down to today's charges. This date of service was the 19th. Going to highlight the line, enter the amount paid, click the Add button. Notice that in the top right-hand corner, I still have $3 remaining out of my total of $6. Going to enter the remaining portion. Clicking Add again. Then click Close. Now I can see the payment that was applied to each of the line items. Notice in the lower half of the screen, I can choose to see the unapplied payments. I can double click on one of those unapplied payments and apply that to this encounter or to any other encounter in the patient's list. If I don't wish to apply this, I'm simply going to close it. If I wanted to create a refund for this unapplied patient balance, I can use this Create Refund button at the top right. When finished applying payments, click Close.